In the next reaction, a phosphate is transferred from 1,3-diphosphoglyceric acid to ADP to make ATP by substrate level phosphorylation, leaving behind 3-phosphoglyceric acid. Now remember again, this reaction, like all of those in the second stage of glycolysis, is occurring twice per starting molecule of glucose. The reaction is catalyzed by phosphoglycerate kinase. It's also exergonic with a standard free energy change at delta G0 of minus 4.5 kilocalories per mole. In this reaction, the endergonic synthesis of ATP by substrate level phosphorylation is coupled to a much more exergonic reaction, the hydrolysis of 1,3-diphosphoglyceric acid. This reaction is reversible, the arrows can tell you that, and in active cells it's very rapid, which, by the way, is why we saw earlier that the concentration of G3P in cells is usually very low. Now, why do you think we would refer to 1,3-diphosphoglyceric acid as having a very high energy phosphate linkage? Because the hydrolysis of a phosphate from 1,3-diphosphoglyceric acid is very exergonic. To demonstrate this for yourself, write the reaction as the sum of an ATP dehydration synthesis reaction plus a 1,3-diphosphoglyceric acid hydrolysis reaction. You can refer to some of the examples of this sort of thing that I presented earlier to get you started. The next two reactions are each modestly endergonic and freely reversible. First, the phosphate group on the 3-phosphoglyceric acid, or 3PG, is shifted to the number 2 carbon by a mutase in a reversible endergonic reaction. Then, 2PG is converted to phosphoenol pyruvate, or PEP, in another reversible endergonic reaction. Like 1,3-diphosphoglycerate, phosphoenol pyruvate, PEP, is also a very high energy phosphate compound. In this quite exergonic reaction, delta G0 equals minus 7.2 kilocalories per mole, the hydrolysis of phosphoenol pyruvate is coupled to the synthesis of another molecule of ATP. The enzyme catalyzing this reaction is pyruvate kinase. In energetic terms, the large amount of free energy released by the hydrolysis of the phosphoenol linkage in PEP is what drives the endergonic ATP synthesis. Again, demonstrate this to yourself by writing the overall reaction as the sum of two separate reactions. Pyruvate kinase catalyzes a biologically irreversible reaction, and the enzyme is allosterically regulated. The enzyme is inhibited by ATP, citric acid or citrate, and long-chain fatty acids of the sort you would find after they were immediately hydrolyzed from the glycerol backbone. And the enzyme is stimulated by fructose 1,6-diphosphate and by phosphoenol pyruvate itself. What is the logic for how each of the allosteric effectors I just told you about regulates pyruvate kinase?